About 2 years ago, I started making this video, with the goal to find the easiest way of learning bar rides. A trick that I thought was one of the coolest looking things you can do on a bike ever since I saw Hacker do them on Getting Awesome. So I got the courage together and started figuring things out. Until I made it to the point where I could actually jump onto the handlebars. But then this happened. And I just stopped trying. But I don't give up that easily. So this summer I had a new goal, finally learn this damn trick. I started from zero again. But this time, before doing anything else, I spent some time getting used to standing on the handlebars, to figure out how it feels and how to jump off. Pretty easy on grass, but once you take it to a smooth surface, you notice how the bike reacts to every little move you make. The next step was to get back to jumping onto the handlebars. Before jumping into your demise, it's a good idea to practice jumping over the bars first, to build that confidence. And the easiest way to do that is to either have someone hold the bike for you, or strap it up between two pallets using a tensioning belt. With this, I got rid of the return barrier in my head that kept me from committing my weight over the bars. And shortly after, I was able to jump directly on there again. At this point I thought I should try to stand up right away to prevent this from happening again. But I quickly realized that any kind of control would explode away whenever I tried to stand up. I also tried to push myself along while holding onto something, which didn't work, and I practiced on the strapped down bike a lot, which also didn't help. So I changed my plan to learning how to balance on there without taking my hands off first, which I tried for 2 weeks straight. With no progress at all. So I thought I'd make it easier for myself and attach some platforms to stand on. They weren't solid enough, but then I figured, why not just attach some brake levers horizontally? And they actually made it much easier to stand on the handlebars when not rolling, and subsequently had me realize my only problem was the steering, because when rolling, I still jumped off right away every time. So I took them back off and decided to focus on nothing but steering. It had finally clicked, and from here I was progressing every single day. This nicely shows the basic concept of how learning motor skills works. As you can only really focus on one thing at a time, you look for the thing you can work on, focus on that until it becomes muscle memory, so your brain does it without focusing on it, and then you can focus on the next thing. Pretty simple actually, but sometimes the difficulty is in figuring out what to focus on. Once I had gotten to the point where I felt like I didn't need to focus on the steering anymore and was able to just roll along staying on the bars, it was time to try standing up. Just 2 weeks after I initially figured out the steering, I was actually doing proper bar rides. But at what point can I say I've learned them? I figured if I did a long, controlled one, jumped back on the pedals at the end, and rode away, I could call it mission accomplished. So that's what I set out to do. Mission accomplished, and this time without any serious crashes. My bike, however, didn't get away as unscathed as I did. The hundreds of tumbles really took their toll. One of the bolts on the top reservoir of my left brake lever got rattled loose, so the brake leaked oil, and the bolt got bent by the impacts. And when I opened up the reservoir to bleed the brake, a chunk of the threads simply fell off. Then there were the stem and bar ends that constantly got smashed into the ground, which I counteracted by cushioning them. And I don't even know how this happened. It's on the side of my back foot, exactly where the crank arm passes, but the arm isn't bent, so it must have been repeated impacts strong enough to make the arm hit and chip away at the frame. These impacts also went into the pedals, which seem to have taken them fine except for heavy scratching, but I'm still glad I put on these plastic ones instead of my nice Crank Brothers pedals. And then there's some minor stuff like scratches on the top tube from standing on the paint. Or how my shoes have rubbed the black of the bars where I was standing. The bike was pretty beaten up, but after giving it some love and care, it's back in fully working condition. All in all, this was pretty much the hardest learning process I've had on a bike so far. Not in terms of how long it took, but the dedication it needed. If we don't count the failed attempt 2 years ago, it took me 1.5 months of constant practice with only a few rest days in between, and pretty much no other riding. In the end, I've learned one of the coolest looking things you can do on a bike though, and I'd say that's a fair trade. This video took a long time to make. If you liked it and want to help me make more, check out my Patreon page using the link in the description. Thanks to everyone who supports me on there, and thanks for watching.